I'm a mother, teacher, guide and a friend, and these are my life lessons. I'm Dr. Neeti Kaushik and welcome to my channel, Nitty Gritty with Dr. Neeti Kaushik.
Hi, welcome to Nitty Gritty with Dr. Neeti Kaushik. There are so many times some signs which come in unknowingly where we are not able to figure out whether are we depressed or they are just passing by. So the signs unconsciously come into our behaviors, unconsciously come into our existence, and probably we need to look into those signs so very seriously, because these signs surely can be the signs for depression. These testing times, it's very, very important to keep a tap on all of us and to keep seeing what's happening in us more than also what's happening around us. So let's discuss about those signs. First and the foremost, sleeping too much or sleeping too little. Both ways, either ways. If in case you are used to sleeping for about 7 hours or 8 hours or 6 hours, and all of a sudden you have started sleeping for a longer duration of time, for many, many hours during the day, during the afternoon, in the evening and at night, and you don't feel like getting up and facing the world, sure shot, there's a sign that you need to introspect. Or else you are sleepless. You just wake up in the middle of the night, you know where, and you really don't know. And your thoughts take you all over the places. That's again another sign needs to be looked into. Now we move to the second sign. You isolate yourself, or else you become too friendly. Either you don't feel good enough to talk to anybody, meet anybody, and you want to be cocooned into your own bedroom. Or else there is a sign when you are becoming overactive, too much of an activeness is there in your lifestyle, and you are unnecessarily talking to people and unnecessarily showcasing a lot of things, and you are just tapping people here and there, wherein you want that there should be somebody to listen to you. So that is another sign. Third important sign, you react inappropriately. Either you are too loud in your reactions, all of a sudden you have started answering back anybody and everybody. There's so much of an emotional turmoil going on inside you that you are not ready to listen to anybody, and your immediate action is a reaction rather than listening and then answering somebody back. There is also a possibility that you're not reacting, but at the same time, spur of a minute, anything happens and you start crying. Anything you see, you start crying. You are inconsolable. You are crying day in, day out. Small little things, you're not able to keep your emotions at intact. So that's the third sign. Fourth important sign, you get tired very, very easily. And you have absolutely no energy in you. Yes, of course, when we are getting over COVID or else because of any other ailment, physically, it takes a little while. It takes some days to get back to our normal self, usual self, and get energetic. But if in case there's something like this is not there, and it has been quite some time since you were sick and still you are not energetic, you are feeling very lazy, you're feeling very let down, sign for you to watch. The next point is appetite. Our appetite goes for a toss. Either we stay hungry for long hours, or else we are eating just too much, hogging on all the junk food all the time. Every hour we want to put something into our mouth, which will give us a false sense of eating carbs, which are giving us a false sense of energy. So that's another point. Last but not the least, we become very indecisive. Should I meet my friends or should I not? Should I pick up the call or should I not? Should I go and talk to the family members or should I not? Should I ignore all the calls? Should I be approachable? So we are totally indecisive about what we are planning to do now and what we are planning to do next. And we just do not know where we are going and where we are heading to. What's the solution? Any loss, any problem, time is the only solution. But yes, there are small, we say piecemeals, there are small little things which can really, really go a long way to help you out. What are those? First and foremost, I'll always say, I rate that as the most important thing, and that is prayer. When I say prayer, there are so many ways to pray. Pray, we are not going to be praying only for asking for things. We are going to be praying for keeping ourselves into the kind of happiness quotient that we have always been, or into the kind of satisfying feeling that is already being there. So first and foremost, this very simple and very important and a very beautiful prayer is Ho'oponopono prayer, which I always say that works wonders for self-healing. When we talk of self-healing, the prayer is like you put your hand on your heart and you simply think about it, that you are saying this to your own self. And these are magical words. And they say, I love you. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Thank you. So these four lines, these four sentences, they are miraculous, because if wholeheartedly you will be saying these prayers once in the morning, once in the evening, and if more than that, nothing like it, even for 5 minutes, they are going to bring a lot of calmness into you. Second important thing, I always say, daily actions, how you begin your day is going to change your entire attitude towards sadness, towards thought process. If you start your day with the gratitude, if you start your day with thankfulness, if you start with your day thinking of what you had 10 years ago and what you have now, those 10 years down the line, they have made so much of a difference in your life, and you have grown spiritually, you have grown emotionally, you have grown mentally, and probably you have grown in the entire aura of your own self. So that will make a lot of difference to you. Then I move to another thing. Yes, when you are paying gratitude, pay gratitude for everything which is all around you. Start your day with that. You are definitely going to be healed. Very, very important. Don't look at your phone. At least don't look at your phone for the first 1 hour when you wake up. Because that's the time what you are feeding in your body, in your system, in your mind, in your thought is going to run your entire day. So if you are grateful, if you are praying, if you are planning your day, if you are thinking of what you have to do now, this is where it's going to lead you towards a better life purpose, towards a better happiness, towards a better thought process, towards deviating yourself, because when you will be seeing the gadgets or when you will be on the media, you will be finding half the world, you know, either showcasing something really sad or bad or not up to the mark or something which hurts you. So again, if you start your day with the bad news or a inappropriate news or a hurtful news or something which is again striking off the balance of yours, the whole day will go like that. Better keep your gadget away at least for an hour so that you can revamp your mind to think better and you for that to last better. Second last important thing is your sleep schedule. Try and by all means sleep at a fixed time. Even if you are not feeling sleepy, listen to chants, listen to mantras, listen to something which can induce a little more sleep in you, or read a book, go off to sleep at the same specific time slots, which is going to help you a lot. Spend time in nature. Nature is the best healer. It can heal you like anything. Spend time in the garden. Spend time watering plants. Spend time in the fresh air. Spend time in the sun. Spend time walking barefoot in the park. That's all going to heal you like anything. And start coming back, scheduling your things that you were always doing. Your hobbies, your love for things that was making you happy. Gradually get into that mode. So I hope all this is going to really help you. I'll end up with a small little sentence which I read about a couple of days ago, which was very beautiful. You are braver than you know, and you are stronger than you think. So stay healthy, stay happy, stay blessed. And may you all come over all the kind of issues that you have been facing for such a long time. May you be healthy, wealthy, and may you be cheerful. And may you shine like you have always been. God bless you. Thank you so much. Thanks for connecting with Nitty Gritty with Dr. Neeti Kaushik.